was channel surfing, and Doug Batchelor came on. And I'd always had an interest in prophecy, and I'd studied the best I could, but I was still very confused on the subject. At a time in my life, I wasn't going to church, and I was depressed. And he was doing his Amazing Facts seminar, and I loved it. I watched it a couple more times on TV, bought the whole series, watched it, bought his second series. Then eventually I started to go to church. I was baptized 2 years ago, and then I got involved doing outreach with Chris James. He does a really cool thing where on the holidays we put candy in a bag with a glow track, so we can say Merry Christmas, Happy Valentine's, which is really cool because you get smiles. But it leaves an opening to give out Bible studies. And so one day we came into Golden Village.
I was at the Golden Village in Milton, Chinese restaurant in Milton Freewater, Oregon, and these two people walked in that I didn't know.
We gave him a gift bag, Happy Labor Day. And then we asked him if he wanted to get to know the Bible better.
And I said yes. And I was interested in Bible prophecy because where I was attending church at that time wouldn't even touch it.
We asked if he wanted to know his Bible better, and we handed him a Bible study. And then we sat down and he let me know that he was into Bible prophecy, which is one of my interests myself. So we had a short conversation on Bible prophecy.
I'm interested in the book of Revelation because where I go to church now, wouldn't even touch it. And they said there was so many different ways of interpreting the prophecy.
We got his information, and then probably a month and a half later, I went to visit him. Mike asked me if there was a Wednesday night Bible meeting, and I said, yeah. So we went to that, and he went every Wednesday.
And then I started going to Sabbath.
Coming to find out later, like Mike, like myself, had been tuning in to Blue Mountain Television, where he'd been watching Doug Batchelor and Kenneth Cox, which I think really planted the seed for his baptism.
In November of last year, I was baptized and become a member of Milton Seventh-day Adventist Church, all because of a glow track and prayer, mostly prayer.